grass that we used to play on, right, and chew it up. Now we've got that artificial surface. You see the pellets go up. Still a nice play by the defense.
They'll look to throw. Looking middle, and it's incomplete.
One thing that I've liked defensively is that they've shown them a lot of different looks here in the first half. They've come after them. They've sat back. I think that's what you need to do to keep an offense guessing.
And they certainly have kept them on their toes. That's why they haven't had much success on the scoreboard. The Cowboys on third down, 0 for 3 to this point. They could use a conversion. This is third and 7. They're going to look to throw. And incomplete. The contact made the ball roam free and brings up fourth down.
You hear the calls for a penalty, but I just don't think so. I think in this situation, the defender is making sure his guy can hold on to the football. So I don't see anything to warrant to the flag.
No, I'm with you. There was contact, but I'm happy they kept that flag in the back pocket. So he splits the uprights and has to be a nice feeling. Right when it left his foot, knew it was good.
Yeah, just like a good three-point shooter in basketball, right? Release the ball, fall back on defense without even looking. You know it's going in the hoop.
And he'll take this up past the 20 and down at the 22-yard line. And Tampa Bay trots out there now. And we'll see how this is played. Offensively, they've got the lead. Not a whole lot of time left. What do you think, Charles?
Well, it's tempting to try and add to your lead, but a mistake there, that can change things in a big way. I say go ahead, take the knee, get on out for the half.
He'll rifle this one deep right side. And got his man complete. And now before this first down play, we're going to get a timeout here as they stop it with 28 seconds to go in the first half of play. So the line of scrimmage moves all the way across the 50 now as they come up first and 10. Jameis now on first down. And he'll lay out and pull it in. What a diving catch there. A very good gain on first down. 9 yards on the dump off. Now the Cowboys going to burn the first of their timeouts as they'll stop the clock with 12 seconds to go in this first half. They'll run it now out of the gun. And a short gain there down to the 37-yard line. Only a yard on the pickup, so from a good situation on second and 2, it's now third and 1. And we're going to get a timeout with 2 seconds remaining in the second quarter. So with 2 ticks left here in the half, on is the field goal unit. This from 54 yards away. And Gostkowski's kick is good. So we have reached halftime here with the visiting Buccaneers out on top. As we send you on over to Orlando for Jonathan Coachman in our EA Sports Halftime Report. Take it away, Coach. The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. That'll be taken in the end zone. Out come the Cowboys now as he'll go on offense first here in this third quarter. They have the ball here for the inaugural drive of the second half. Pretty big deficit, though. We'll see what adjustments were made in that locker room.
And I never want to make something more important than it actually is, right? I don't want to create more hype than what is there.
This is a
I'm doing it, though. This is a really important drive. And we often talk about teams scripting plays to start a game. A lot of them script to start the second half, too. And they're scripting something that they expect to get them into the end zone and back into this game.
We'll see if he rifles one that's intercepted. Sua Cravens with a pick. And they are going to set up shop at the 40-yard line. First possession of the third quarter, an interception, so maybe a second-half tone setter.
Indeed, and not the tone they wanted to set. That's the equivalent of running out the wrong door and running into your pool instead of running out onto the field. A real dud for that one.
Has that happened to you before?
No, but I've heard stories about teams actually doing that back in the good old days. Well, we just saw a great example of what we talked about with his coach prior to the game. He's definitely one of the better linebackers at reading a play and flowing to make the stop before it turns into something big.
Again, it's Jones. And he's going to get this inside the 30. It's a 10-yard pickup, and it moves the chains.
They're trying to show that they can run the ball and protect this lead. Give it to the backs, play a little bit of keep away, don't you think?
And that's probably a good philosophy at this point, going to make that defense stand up and stop them. The Bucs want Jones to take this running back job and run with it, literally and figuratively, as he's back there on first down. Here's Ajayi. And this has been a familiar sight all afternoon as they stop him behind the line. This will be a 2-yard loss on the play, and it'll be second and 12. Again, this to Jones. And maybe a measure of revenge there. He's had his way in this one, but this time they get him behind the line. They'll wind up losing 3 yards here. And they're going to face an uphill battle here on third and long.
Let's go now.
Jameis to throw it. And he couldn't hang on to it through the contact. Incomplete.
Even without a ton of pressure in his face, it just shows how difficult it is to pick apart his own defense. Those guys are sitting back, and they're not playing receivers as much as they're playing the eyes of the quarterback and when he delivers the ball.
So 3 field goals that he's hit. Now this last one helps him stretch out the lead.
He's been solid, hasn't he? And he lives up to the adage that every offensive coach has ever said to us. We want to end every possession with a kick, right? For them, it's either extra point, field goal, or at worst, a punt. In this case, it's been 3s.
And this return nets positive as he gets past the 25 and up to the 27-yard line. And now Dallas gets set to take the field. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious.
Oh, the Buccaneer pressure too much. Down he goes. Derek Barnett in there to drop him, and it'll be a loss of about 8.
I know there'll be a little bit of criticism there because they went right back to the air after the huge pickup and end up getting sacked. That's often a play that you make. You feel like you've got momentum on your side.
Unfortunately, the O-line failed to hold up to try to keep that momentum going. Now, meanwhile, a pass that should have been intercepted, but it winds up falling incomplete. Throwing the football, he's not as sharp as he was last week when he was over 70%. Right now, he's under 50%.
Well, that comes from extra game film, extra time. You know those guys watched him all week, saw how precise he was.
And it's intercepted. Sua Cravens with a pick. And his guys are going to take over at the 31-yard line. Well, and I saw the pressure coming at him. That just looked problematic. Hit him as he threw it, and the interception ensued.
Let me pay homage to the man who stood in this spot before. He always talked about how much pressure is in the face of a guy, and can he step into a throw? And when you can't do that, oftentimes interceptions result.
Just what you want on a first down run. Call it 8 yards, and it's second and 2. They'll go again to Jones. Jones breaking from the cut, and he's into the end zone. Touchdown, Buccaneers. Ronald Jones, his second touchdown of the game, his 3rd on the year. And the interception by the Bucs D leads to a touchdown. And he knocks it through. Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. This is taken about 7 yards deep. And he'll wind up about 4 yards shy of where he would have been if he had taken a knee, as they'll start at the 21-yard line.
Gone, 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 gone!
Trying to shake off the interception. He'll look to throw, eluding the pressure right. And he's taken down, trying to do a little too much, getting outside of the pocket, and it results in a sack. Quan Alexander. And before this second down play, we'll get a whistle, a signal, and a timeout. It's just their first, so two remaining as they burn one here in this third quarter. After the sack here, second and 11. The play action fake. They'll look to throw. In trouble here, and down he goes. Back at the 8-yard line.
So, Brandon, we've sat in with a lot of coaches, and when they talk about things they want to accomplish offensively, I'm not sure that sack and sack are on their play sheet.
After the sack, they'll come up now, third and long.
Yeah, I wouldn't be surprised to see them run the ball here just to try and get some space.
Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. And he's going to be intercepted a third time. Sua Cravens with a pick. And he is going to get this one back to the 20-yard line. This home crowd, they're happy with that call.
I like the way you said happy there, right? The so-called good guys didn't get a call. They feel like it's been that way all afternoon. You feeling their pain?
They finally got one.
Yes, they did.
Now a play fake here on first down. And this is going to be caught. He won the fight for the football. And that goes for a gain of 31. The last drive, he threw the pick, but he's not shy. He's going downfield again there.
And you can't be, because if you back off after throwing an interception, your whole game plan just goes right out the window, and it makes things easier for a defense. And you and I both know there isn't a quarterback in this league that's any good that doesn't throw an interception occasionally, and they usually bounce back in a big way. I've seen guys throw five and still find a way to win the game in the end.
They work again from the 38 on second and 10. To throw now on second and 10. And he's going to be sacked. They sack him back right at the midfield stripe. Levante David coming with pressure. He drops him on the blitz for a loss of 12. The Cowboys on third down. A pretty woeful 0 for 5 thus far. This will be third and forever. He'll drop to throw. He's going to air one out. That's going to be knocked away and incomplete. It's been this way most of the afternoon, hasn't it? This secondary, it really put this receiving core on lockdown.
Listen, they've worked together like a basketball team that's playing excellent defense, great communication, doesn't matter whether it's man or zone, and especially against deep balls, as we saw there, they're not giving up anything to them.
I guess they figure they got to start taking some chances. Here's a big one in this third quarter as he'll go for it on fourth down. From the midfield stripe, they'll look to throw. Flushed out right. And he can't find a receiver, and he's brought down. Kendall Beckwith in there to record another sack. Their sixth of the afternoon. It's a giant. And he's going to get this one down near the 45-yard line. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a second and 9.
Nice job by that defensive front there to hold him to a short gain on first down. Well played, I must say.
Yeah, only getting 1 yard. There was no room to run.
Begin. Ready. Black, 22.
Second down, Winston. A jump underneath to Jones. And he'll get it down here to the 43. He'll get a couple yards on that one. And that's going to bring up a third down.
Hey, stop, let's go.
To throw is Winston. And he can't quite pick it. No interceptions so far. That probably should have been their first, but at least it's fourth down.
I got so much beef, I could barely sleep. Paranoia got me losing on my Z's all day. Good Lord, mama praying on the knees all day. If you still frightened when I up it, I'ma squeeze. Bad companies, bad for your company. Bad companies, bad for your company. In the ski mask, in case you come for me. Got to in the ski mask, in case you come for me. When I say I got beef, they don't want no beef. When they say they got beef, they don't wanna eat. They don't want no steam. She put it on it. Bad. Had a bachelor's degree, PhD while selling, fix the face and fix the weed. Now working on the self-esteem, hit a block, yo, this flock, where you at, pin it, my new map location, be the flock, on the app.
Money and company, nah, bad, I don't need no the company.
You can't hang, baby, hang, we don't want you around here. Ice on my neck, cold, and it's froze, Santa's reindeer. You got bad. It's the same here. Bad company, little bro. You can't hang here. Getting money, soda. Keep on coming. Phone ringing, so you know the jumping. They looking at me. He owe me some money.
I need that.
Hit him with the not crumping.
Why
playing games? They don't want no problems with me. Got good. You know I brought them. Might not hit a bag. Someone send them. Well, opposite,
they
move on. So I
dark shades, too much. I can barely see them. Acting brand new, like I don't see it when I do. Who them folks? Who want too close? Give me room, phony folks. Play it close, do the most, don't they? Bad company, that's bad for your company. Bad company, that's bad for your company. Bad cow disease, now you in a ton of beef. Tucked underneath my new blue dunkaries. Flintstone bust down, call the Maricami. Fruity pepper, bezel, Wilma, Betty, Fred, and Barney. Back. From out of town, I think she model Abercrombie. Wrist game, lucky chummy, told my jeweler leprechaun. I'ma come clean, I got beef. Paranoia got me rolling in my sleeves, okay. Waiting cause I'm up and up the fees. Whole team got beats on their tees all day.
I got so much beef, I could barely sleep. Paranoia got me losing on my Z's all day. Good Lord, mama praying on the knees all day. If you still frightened when I up it, I'ma squeeze.
I'm above average.
They call a podcast Poppy. King goes, I see they tryna copy. Diamonds in the chain, bust down wrists. And you ain't never seen no like this. What? Tell me something I don't know. What? Tell me something I don't know. What? Tell me something I don't know. Like when the drop, whole